Mother government building. Oh, right, I remember now. Okay. So, my high school, mother government building. So I mentioned that, the government building that my mother works in kind of reminds me a lot of a prison. Or at least, you know, built like a prison, whatever. So I went to a high school in Massachusetts, and generally Massachusetts has a pretty good budget. My town has a lot of, like, old white people. I guess old people in general, it doesn't matter white or not, come to think of it. But, so we've got a lot of really old people in my town. It's rather expensive to live in, and so you get a lot of, like, retirees that are like, you know, getting on in years, no children around, so on and so forth. And for the most part, you know, this is fine. Nobody really cares. They don't like paying taxes. Old people don't like paying taxes, from what I can tell. And honestly, I guess it kind of makes sense. A lot of people don't like paying taxes. But these people especially don't like paying taxes on improving the school system. So for me, you know, being in the school system, it was kind of a problem because, hey, you know, I would love to have... I don't have the delivery anymore. Ah, whatever. You know, I'd love to have my school system actually have proper funds. Like, they were... Oh, I did have Jade. Whoopsie. Oh, well, not the end of the world. Oh, and he doesn't check the TV. Eh, whatever. It's... I will forget constantly. What is it? Friday that's the next one? But... let's just drop the leak off. It's not the end of the week. I don't even know. I guess we have Emily. Yeah, let's figure out what Emily, Clint, and Gus like. I don't think I actually looked what Emily likes. Okay. Emily likes emeralds, jades, survival burgers. She's expensive. Or we can just give her salads. Cool. Emily, Clint, and Gus. Oh, right. Dude loves... Oh, also parsnips. Yeah, this guy loves gems and stuff, which is less than useful. Okay, what about Gus? What is Gus like? Diamonds. Also parsnips. Fucking parsnips, man. They're like the wonder food. I just realized I've probably got a bunch of parsnips that are fully grown down here. That I've been completely ignoring. As well as a bunch of honey. Whoopsie. I guess I gotta come down here more often. Oh well. But yeah, so my high school, I mean, it was an okay school. But it clearly needed some work. It needed some renovation. The air conditioning barely worked. The heating was awful. I mean, even more so, non-existent in a lot of cases. It was an okay school, but it definitely had issues. But the really unique defining thing about my school that I always found just so strange was my high school was designed by the guy that did most of the prisons in Massachusetts. Like, straight up, guy that makes prisons, made my school. And that's it. There were two windows. There were two windows in my entire high school that opened. Both in the science wing on the third floor. All of the other windows never could open. So, you know, at the beginning or at the end of the season... let's see. So this is Gus. Beginning and end of the season, like, you know, kind of when it's still hot left over, like, kind of early fall and stuff, and it can get up to 90, yeah, it would be 90 in that building. It was awful. And same thing at the beginning of spring or beginning of summer before they properly turned on the AC. It was dumb. Okay, we don't care about Evelyn because he can't do anything with that. George, we're good. Gus likes parsnips. Clint, I think, was the other one. Unfortunately, I organized mine in alphabetical, and that's not useful. I think Clint also liked parsnips, right? Yep. Everybody fucking loves parsnips for some reason. I'm okay with it. So we're gonna go stock us a chef and a other guy. Okay, that's fine. Let's see, what else is there? I'm rather sleepy, so like my ability to story right now is kinda butts. Prisons equals schools seems about right. Yeah. They definitely had some like weird management stuff. I'm trying to think of if there's ever any like major issues. Join us, thrive, that's terrifying. Gee, I don't know. I'm trying to think of like dumb school stories again. Oh man, here's one. I was always kind of angry at, you know, how things were managed, just because it always felt like teaching was kind of secondary to a lot of my teachers. You know, I mentioned math lawyer a little while ago, and I don't think I ever mentioned this. So, freshman and sophomore year, actually no, eighth grade, freshman and sophomore year, every single one of my math teachers had been a cheerleader for the NFL, for the Patriots, at various points in their life. So my eighth grade one had retired from being a cheerleader. Maybe, you know, a couple of years before working, you know, for the NFL as a cheerleader. My ninth grade math teacher had been one back in, like, the 70s or 80s or something silly like that. And that was about the same time block that my 10th grade math teacher did. Of all of these three women, only my 9th grade teacher actually had any business in a classroom. My 8th grade one was a ditz, and she'd rather us just watch have us watch the Goonies and oh, damn, I didn't get the treasure. Cheerleader math teachers. Yeah. And like you'd think this would be awesome because they'd be really like attractive or whatever, I don't know. Not like I generally cared. These are the awkward days where you're in high school and you'll get the random boner and you're like, I don't want this random boner. And it's like, nope, you have it for the entire math class. Have fun. Puberty. Great stuff. But so yeah, cheerleader math teachers. Only the eighth grade one was reasonably attractive. The other two had grown, quite rotund in their old age. They're like 40 and 50 a piece or something like that. Have a goddamn parsnip. Should probably figure out what the museum guy wants too, but whatever. But yeah, so my ninth grade math teacher actually liked math. Was a hard teacher. My eighth grade one was useless. She never had quite graduated from cheerleader mentality. And my 10th grade math teacher had no business being anywhere near education because she could barely communicate. It was awful. Blacksmith wants gems and gold bars more than parsnips. It's true, but I'm also really lazy and cheap and I have a fuck ton of parsnips, which I should probably buy some more seeds for. Just because I'm gonna have quite a lot. Oh, this is not the store. I could go in and try and buy stuff from George, but I think he'd just get offended at me. What other quests do we have? Gold bar Haley. That I can do for easy enough. Yeah, so she spoke in, like, noises. Like, straight up, she barely could communicate, and, would frequently punish people for going ahead in the book. And, like, asking questions. Because what she would do is she would kind of, like, write a couple formulas on the board and be like, figure it out. And some of us would. Some of us would figure it out really fast. A lot of the rest of us would struggle. I was one of the lucky few. I was sitting next to a friend of mine. We were really good friends for only this math class. And then after that, he never really talked to me again. But so... So, I went ahead a lot just because she didn't teach. You know, you had to learn from the book anyway, so fuck her lesson plan. Let's just go down the book page by page, solving all the problems. Oh no, is this another person who punishes intelligence? Not so much intelligence. She was totally up for people that were smart. She didn't like it when people went ahead, though, because if you finished the problem set, you had to go around the rest of the room teaching everybody else how to do it. So for me, if I finished the problem set in 5 minutes, I had to go to everybody else and coach them until they got it. Literally doing her job for her. Now, I will admit, teaching is actually the best way to learn material. Because if you understand it perfectly and you can perfectly reproduce it so somebody else can learn it, then you've succeeded. And you're going to know that material a hell of a lot better than just learning it yourself. However, as a 10th grader, I really felt quite offended that the responsibility fell on me to do the teaching for her. And after a while, I just did all the problem sets, and then I would pretend to be having issues while I played, Game of Squares, with my friend, because we had nothing better to do. But there was one day where her computer was broken, and she couldn't figure out what was wrong, and me being, you know, one of the main computer geeks in my school, just because we didn't have a whole lot of them, so I had a fair idea of how to do things. And eventually I find out that she's just unplugged the keyboard. And I also realize that her mouse is busted, like it's not working. So I get her mouse working, and I'm like moving the mouse cursor around, and she got really angry at me because she had intentionally busted the mouse so she wouldn't have to use it. Because apparently using the mouse was too hard, and so what she would do was the entire desktop of the computer was just a bunch of icons, and she just used the arrow keys to select them. And then she never browsed the internet. The internet was like a mystical wizard thing for her. All she would do would be like open up shortcuts to PDF lesson plans or something like that. I honestly can't tell you. But that is literally what she would do. That was her thing, and it was kind of horrifying. Oh, he's doing exercises. Okay, I was like, why is there a naked man in that room? And why can't I see it? But yeah, so she's just... I don't know, she was just like the most useless math teacher I've ever had. And she was furious at me for this. But, so the funny thing about her, specifically, was, her name was Barbara. And I had a pretty low opinion of her. I don't know if she was really a bad person, but I didn't like her that much. Just because, you know, a teacher that can't teach really isn't worth much, in my eyes. So, one of the things she would do, seeing as she was a rather, ineffective person, every Monday she would ask people, you know, what did you do? What did you do for the weekend? You know, where'd you go? Did you do anything interesting? Yada, yada, yada. And for the most part, like, generally, most of us did nothing, because whatever. And, you know, maybe we'd talk about it, maybe we wouldn't. But she'd get really pushy about it, because it was very obvious she didn't want to teach. I had just watched the original zombie movie, Night of the Living Dead. If you guys have never seen Night of the Living Dead, it's awful. But it's probably worth watching just for the sake of, you know, history, I guess. We'll drop that off. I have too many parsnips in my inventory. Let's drop stuff off. Like, I want to sell stuff, but I don't know what I want to sell, because I don't know what people want for gifts. You know, alternatively, fuck it. I don't need all these potatoes. I'm probably not going to use them. Let's see. Spring crops. I needed potato. Well, luckily I've got a potato. There we go. Let's go drop that off before I make that mistake again. Awful, aka best movie ever. I mean, honestly, it's just kind of low bar quality. It's not like a bad movie. It's not like Holy Mountain or anything like that, where it's just such a like weird, awful experience that it almost ends up being good. This is just kind of like old and campy because they literally can't do anything better. Couldn't have done anything better at the time. But whatever, it's probably still worth watching just for the sake of movie history. But so we, so me and my family had decided to watch it for funsies. And it was not a bad movie, but so one of the first lines in the entire movie, one of the first lines in the entire movie is, "They're coming to get you, Barbara," as the main female character's brother, makes a wisecrack about somebody coming to, like, attack her or something like that, seconds before getting attacked by a zombie. I realize this is spoilers, but the movie's, like, 50 years old plus, so I'm sorry. Whatever. But so, for Night of the Living Dead, I mentioned to this dunce of a math teacher that I'd seen it, and she's like, "Oh man, you know, I really like that movie." And so I just quote the movie at her, you know, saying, "They're coming to get you, Barbara." Just because, you know, hey, she actually, like, knows about something that we have a shared experience here. I might as well crack a joke. She sends me to the principal's for threatening her. No joke. I didn't have to go back to the math class for the rest of the week because the principal thought I was, in fact, threatening her. Fucking dumb people. I don't know. The death of education is because everyone is stupid. It just hurts a little when, like, these things happen, and I'm just like, man, I remember when I was, like, you know, starry-eyed and everything was awesome. And then, yeah, why are you always around such horrible people? I just notice things, like I'm paying attention or, like, I'm on the wrong side of it. I don't know. It makes for interesting stories, but that's the extent of it. Let's see. Somebody wanted a gold bar. Haley. Who the hell is Haley? That's Harvey. Krobus, Morrow, Haley, blonde chick. All right, let's go see if I can find her. Let me zoom around. I don't know. I had kind of like a weird education system. The thing is, you bounce around enough school systems, you end up picking up all the stupid just because of general proximity. Oh God, it's making me think about North Carolina. Let's see, was there anything else to really talk about there? No, I don't think so. Oh, that's Pam. Guess I could try and find Haley's house. Just stalking people mounted on a horse. Well, let's figure out which one's Haley's house. Okay, so she's down in one of these. She's probably not going to be there, honestly, but whatever. If we don't, we'll just fish outside until she goes home and then creep in or something. Hey, there she is. You wanted to go bar. Give me money. Oh, that's exactly what I needed. Hehe, I'm so happy. We got a new achievement. Gopher. And money. Awesome. Hey, that means I actually get can get a new hat if I want. Well, seeing as I have nothing better to do, let's go check to see if there's any interesting hats, honestly. Okay, so, so, that's it for Massachusetts for the time being. So I lived in North Carolina for a very short period of time. Like, an incredibly short period of time. Right, Mystery Cart's not gonna be up yet. But, the hardwood is. So let's go get that. But, so I was in North Carolina for, like, 3/4 of a year. Just enough to finish up 6th grade, and just enough to, just enough to finish sixth grade and start 7th grade. I think I got like halfway through 7th grade or something like that before I left for Massachusetts. But I was there long enough to get a very interesting experience with that school system. So I don't know if you guys have been, I'm going to say down south, but like, you know, in an area where education isn't important. Like, I make some disparaging comments about my school in Massachusetts, but, like, we were top school in the state for all the time I was in, public school, and better than most private schools, too, for, like, the time I was in high school. At least that's what we were ranked as far as standardized tests. I don't know. People could have been lying to me, and I honestly didn't give enough of a shit to care. But, so, but, so, while I was, what is that? Oh, that's just a rock. I thought that bush had, like, a weird purple fruit coming off the top. So, North Carolina was weird. The school had a lot of issues, and its solutions were bad. The population was, like, I want to say 50% black, 40% white, and then some Hispanic and Asian and whatever else just thrown in. But for the most part, it was a very heavy black and white population. And for the most part, it didn't matter, but... Okay. Wow, we can actually buy a lot of hats now. If we wanted to be goofy. Let's be slightly goofy. Hey, I'm JoJo. Or I'm Joestar. Yeah. But, so... like, for the most part, it didn't matter, but a lot of the black students really, really vocally did not care about school. And, like, fine, that's their thing. But it was inconvenient. There were a lot of guys that would vocally profess their, like... Wear the bonnet. No. Would vocally profess their desire to be, like, a rap star. Or a basketball player. Or a rap star basketball player. And, you know, for the most part, it didn't really matter. You know, I didn't care. I was just taking classes. But since I had transferred into the school district, they didn't know where to place me, so they threw me in a lot of, like, middling low classes. Which kind of sucked. And so, I was in one specific earth science class. My teacher had just immigrated to the U.S. from South Africa to teach earth science at the middle school level for some whatever reason. You had stupid optimistic black people in your school, too. Yeah, it was sad. I felt bad for a lot of them. A lot of them were incredibly short. Like, I'm not a tall dude, but I was taller than most of them, and I'm like, your basketball dreams are going to be short and sad, just like you. I never said this because I was a squeaker and I almost never talked to people in middle school because, yeah, that's another story. But anyway, so I was in this earth science class with a South African teacher, really nice guy, really tried hard to teach things. My class was not having any of it. They wanted nothing to do with education. I think, honestly, I'm the only person that should have passed that class because most of the other people would, like, walk in and out, swear at the teacher, throw things, and I was just sitting there being like, I can't talk to people, I can't interact with people, I actually had, like, a running tally of the teacher's verbal tics because they were hilarious. And, like, the poor guy was really honestly trying to, like, do well by his students, but it just was not working. Even I had kind of, like, a low opinion of him, just because he had no handle over anybody. Let's see, but, I also feel kind of bad for him because the administration kind of messed him up a bunch. Because, we had four different classrooms that we cycled through. Which is not an easy thing to do when your class is already, like, super unruly. It sounds like hell. I mean, I was only there for half of a year. But, so we move out. And I get an email from my professor. Or professor, teacher. Too young for professors at this point. I get an email from my teacher asking me what moving company I had used. Or, like, storage? I'm not entirely sure. But effectively, I got a message from this guy asking me, like, how the move out was, because he was moving back to, hey, there we go, fish are worth more, or chance to find treasure doubled. Wait, These are different. I thought there was supposed to be something about crab pots never needing bait anymore. I guess they patched that out. I guess because crab pots are useless. But yeah, the poor guy actually just was quitting and going back to South Africa because teaching at this middle school was just so bad. I felt honestly kind of terrible hearing this. But this is immediately after the movers had destroyed most of my stuff. So I just said, no, you don't want them. Good luck. Or something like that. I don't know. I was in middle school. Whatever. Fish worth 50% more. Oh, your level 5 talent choice affects your level 10. Yeah, honestly, I'm gonna go with a pirate just because I don't make any money from fish. Like, fish are barely worth money to begin with. All skills have 4 level 10 perks based on the level 5 perk. That's fascinating. Yeah, so we're gonna go with pirate just because that gives me a higher chance of filling out the museum. But fish are not the money maker. In fact, honestly, at this point, I'm done fishing. I'm not gonna be fishing anymore. I'm even gonna put the rod away because I have nothing better to do. I'd rather do other stuff. So what's this? Hand around town. People are really thankful. I'm awarding you this month's Best Neighbor Award with a small cash prize. Keep it up. And Egg Festival tomorrow. Okay. Let's see, what else was there? I mean, not really a story, but like... I don't know... Oh, this is a story for you. I don't know if you guys... Oh god, that's a lot of eggs. I don't know if you guys ever had... Well, I assume everybody's had some kind of, like, sex education health class. Along the way, like, in primary or middle school or whatever. So, my middle school, this is, like, right in the kind of heights of, you know, abstinence-only education being kind of, like, the main thing as far as education goes. So, our sex education was awful. Our drug education was pretty top, though. Just because drugs were, like, a serious problem in the area. There were a lot of college students and whatnot. I don't know. Hey, apparently I have a bunch of wine stored up. Good to know. A lot of people did not have sex ed. Weird. All right, whatever. Don't come to me for that one. but yeah, so we had no sex ed, but we did have a fair amount of, drug-related stuff. Apparently there's... Wait, no, I missed. There we go. Let's give our animals some lovin'. I really need to get some shears. I have no idea what to do with the pigs. Oh, Baconator's still a baby. Gotcha. I was hoping I'd get truffles at some point. But yeah, there was really not a whole lot about how not to get pregnant. At least until 7th grade. I think 7th grade is when they start getting a little bit more aggressive about the whole don't make babies thing. Here's the problem. I had 3 classmates in 6th grade end up pregnant. Oh wait, no, it was 8th grade where you started learning about babies and whatnot. I don't know. I had 3 classmates in 6th or 7th grade end up pregnant. That was weird. I was not okay with it. And to this day, it's still just like, yeah. Pigs need dirt patches, not grass to dig up truffles. They also need to not be babies. So there's that too. But, like, I think my 5th classmate, like, a 5th classmate was pregnant by the time I was moving out. And I was just like, this is just a failing of the, this is just a failing of the sex education department. How old is that? Yeah, 11 to 12. But, I think it was, like, yeah, actually 12. That is really young. God, that is fucking young. Wow, that's gross, honestly. I don't even want to think about this anymore. Anyway, let's talk about health class. So we didn't have sex ed, but boy did we have drug ed. So for the most part, it's been drilled into my head, you know, don't do drugs, kids. Don't do kids drugs. let's see. But so, you know, that sort of thing's been very heavily drilled into me, and I'm fine with that. I don't honestly care. What the hell do I do with myself today? What do we even have left? Skills. What skills have we not done? Oh, it's just foraging, actually. Foraging is the only thing we haven't completed. Fascinating. I mean, we can give shit to Gus and Willie and Marnie. Well, let's go talk to Marnie, honestly. Or at least stalk Marnie until, we can buy ourselves some shears. So we can start collecting wool, because we can give that as, so we can give that out as a gift to people. Okay, but, so we learned about PCP, we learned about speed, we learned about a lot of things. It was kind of weird, honestly. Because as an 11, 12-year-old, I didn't even know really what drugs were, apart from, like, sometimes in video games, there were, like, hints about drugs and stuff. I don't know. So we would watch movies, we would hear educational things. Oh, right, no, they did give us one sexual education thing, which was literally just a video of a woman giving birth. And it's like, you don't want this to happen to you. And I was like, I'm a dude. That's terrifying. And that's pretty much the extent of what I, like, my interaction with it all. I don't know. So if I find Emily, I think I can give her a salad. Clint and Gus take parsnips. Making friends with everybody's a pain in the ass. But for the most part, I do not remember at all any of the drug education stuff, apart from just, like, what they do and all that jazz. But we had to watch a movie, and it's called The Elevator, and I think you can look it up on YouTube and find it. It is quite possibly the worst movie I've ever watched, and it was very much developed by Dare, or at least, you know, some level of association with these people. Because the entire thing is, like, they had characters representing drugs, and it was awful. Like, the entire movie was poorly written. It wasn't fun to watch. And we had to sit through, like, 3 weeks of watching this movie, because it was, like, a multi-part movie or something like that. And we, I mean, classes were only, like, 30 minutes long-ish. Let's see if I can find the old lady. Wait, I've probably already double-friendshipped her today. Evelyn has already been double friendshipped. Never mind, we escape. Okay, but, so, all I remember is they had, like, really bad songs. Like, it played like an awful Disney movie to begin with, like, just singing, and the characters were, like, kind of creepy parodies of, like, real people that were supposed to be, like, based off of various drugs, which was just kind of uncomfortable to experience as a kid, because it's just, like, these people are creepy and gross. And it was more kind of like an anti-stranger danger movie than an anti-drug movie, because I simply could not read into it enough to really understand really anything of it. It was just like, this is uncomfortable. All right, I'm uncomfortable. Thanks for making me uncomfortable, game. Or not game, class. And that was it. I don't know. Let's see. Who are you? You're Jody. What's Jody like? I'm just throwing food at people right now. Probably salads and stuff. She does not... Oh yeah, she also likes salad. There we go. Everybody eats salad, apparently. I'm just killing time until the saloon opens and I can give the dude another parsnip. I'll have this down at some point, but it honestly seems like just hand everybody parsnips and you win. There we go. Glad you're not the only one that refers to things as a game. I am mildly broken about referring to everything as a game in life. It's bad. But whatever. I don't know. Oh, man. But, just seriously, if you want to watch, like, a truly awful movie, go watch The Elevator. It is so bad. Parsnip salads and strawberries are all you need. Yeah, it takes a little bit longer, but it's, like, way less work. Unfortunately, I'm really tired here, so, like, trying to come up with, like, proper commentary about stories from school. Not the easiest. Can I give him another? I've already given him two gifts. All right, back on the horse. We should work on foraging. So I guess why don't we go back and clean up our yard? Because I don't have much else to deal with here. Okay. Let's see. Haven't encountered any crows yet. Interesting. Alright, well, let's drop those off. Other dumb school stories. Shoot. I mean, in sixth grade, my science teacher, very firmly did not believe in teaching me any of the content he had already taught, in the class. So when I moved to North Carolina, he said, somebody else teach him these things. He has to be ready for the... Oh, I can allow pregnancy. Interesting. I can also sell for some amount of money. There we go. Whoa. Ares looks fine. Yay, Ares. But so, I had to take the science final in middle school with literally none of the information because nobody was going to teach me because nobody wanted to talk to me because I had a really high squeaky voice and it was embarrassing to be around me. As such, I got like a C or, I think I got a C or something like that and I had to redo it like 3 times over the summer before eventually my mother just gave up trying to convince me to do this. How do you prevent pregnancy? Long distance. Done. Winning. Turbo abstinence. Never see the other person you're dating. Live on the other side of the world. Only date dudes. If you're a dude. If you're a chick, I can't help you. My advice is useless. I don't know how his babby formed. I don't know, man. Eat a green bean. No. Oh, know about the cows. There's just a little thing you can turn into. Like, click on and off to prevent pregnancies. Don't... Okay, God, I am super sleepy. This is bad. I played this because it would be simple and I could just, like, chill out and play. But the problem is I'm, like, actually working harder to commentate because I'm tired and don't know what to talk about. Oh, well. Let's see. Yeah, solid advice there. I am a real help. I'm glad I'm not a teacher, honestly. I'd be a bad teacher. And honestly, like, it just wouldn't be very fun for me. I think I'd just get kind of... Hey, pine tar! We can finally make a loom. In fact, it's only pine tar. Humorously enough. Alright, I'm fine with that. Okay, so let's use the sword. Yeah, we might as well clean up our yard as we go along here. Let's move the hoe over a bit. There we go. There we go. These are some ways to do it. And that didn't work at all. Oh, whoops. That's the hoe. Not the axe. Yeah, I don't know what to talk about. Give us your idea for the next class. All of its details for a D&D character. Ugh. I don't know, man. I'm gonna be totally honest. Whenever I play, like, D&D and stuff, I'm, like, power gaming more than anything else. I've played D&D too many times to realize most people playing D&D can't do combat, and most DMs can't deal with, parties that can't do combat. So, like, I did D&D in college, and we had a party of, like, 8 people or something like that. And, you know, we were, like, a good group of people. Like, if you wanted to have, like, a really epic campaign of, like, really goofy shenanigans, these were the people to play with. Unfortunately, the DM was not the person to play with, as she killed the entire party 3 times in 2 sessions. Save for me, because I was the rogue, and I had gone out of my way to get a ring of invisibility, and I literally never showed my character. Up until she had my character randomly get killed. Oh shit, I wasn't supposed to do that. I was actually supposed to let that tree go. Whoops. Alright, whatever. I'm a lumberjack and I don't care. Well, that's fine. But yeah, killing the party 3 times in 2 sittings was awful. And, like, she actively was trying to active god my character to death, too. But yeah, people don't know how to do combat. Like, I love Shell. She doesn't know how to do the combat at all. She's getting better at it, but still. But yeah, it was bad. I had technically done one other D&D campaign, which was more fun, but I was a cleric. And we were playing, like, 4.0 or whatever. But effectively, the party got angry at me for building my character to be, like, combat viable. And told me to switch entirely over to, like, Healy support skills. And everybody else would take, like, a huge amount of time during, everybody would take, like, a huge amount of time whenever it was, like, their turn. And also, my character had, like, really low charisma or something. Because I was, like, I don't know, I was a dwarf and I just treated it as a dump stat, I don't even remember. But effectively, my character was, like, hideous, so the entire party decided I couldn't talk to people. And since we had, like, a rogue with, like, 30 skills or something stupid like that, I couldn't, like, interact with puzzles or anything like that. So the only thing I was good for was healing. So after a while, I just started playing flash games until they needed me. And then I started bringing a pillow and sleeping until they needed me. And then they just started having my character do the healing spell without my input, because they already knew what I was going to do anyway. That's when I just stopped showing up to that campaign. It was awesome at first, and then it was just like a, oh, god. I'm like the epitome of useless to the point where the party replaced me with me. Without needing me for anything. It was not good. It was not good at all. What other D&D stories are there? Oh man, I think I've told this one before, but I'll tell it again. We had this really good friend across the street. His parents were crazy. His older brother was kind of a bully. His younger sister was a brat. And he was the Malcolm in the Middle character that, like, legitimately, I don't know if he was, like, necessarily autistic or anything like that, but he definitely had some, like, developmental issues. Because, you know, socially he was a little bit stunted, even for, like, an elementary schooler. I mean, maybe not. I don't know. I might be judging him a little bit harshly. But, like, poor guy worshipped Goku from, Dragon Ball Z. Like, it was a little much how much this guy loved Goku. To the point where anytime we play D&D, now mind you, we're elementary schoolers, so our D&D campaigns were horribly written, terribly designed, all the characters were stupid, and there's very little redeeming about them. But we're also elementary schoolers, so, like, whatever. Like, nobody cared. It was actually quite pleasant. But, so, this guy always would play as Goku. No matter what. Did I just have to tell us where Goku comes from? Who the fuck do you think we are? There are some people watching these videos, I guarantee you, that have never seen or heard of Dragon Ball Z, because it came out before they were born. I've had people ask me about some of these shows, and I'm like, these were, like, integral to my childhood. What the hell? I don't know. There's also multiple Gokus, but he's, like, the main one, so most people should know what the hell I'm talking about, but not everybody.